Students, good morning, namaste. We are in vector algebra, that is part 18 is completed. I mean part 17 is completed. Now I am going to start the part 18. That is vector product of two vectors. Already we completed dot product, now we are in the cross product. The vector product of two vectors, A bar and B bar, is a vector. That is why it is called as a vector product. And it is defined and denoted as a bar cross B bar is equal to mod A bar, mod B bar, sin theta, n cap. Already we defined, definition we know it, and the notation we know it, A bar cross B bar, and it is defined as a mod A bar, mod B bar, sin theta, n cap. How it is formed? Geometrically interpretation is also given the last video part. Now, some properties are there. Those properties are, number one, the properties of vector product or cross product also. If theta is equal to 0 degrees, theta is equal to 0 degrees means it is a parallel vector. Is it not a parallel vector? Are collinear vectors. Okay, na? Parallel vectors are collinear vectors, are like vectors, are unlike vectors, all are same. They are having the 0 degrees or 180 degrees also. Then, what is the result of A bar cross B bar? It is mod A bar, mod B bar, sin theta, n cap, we know each other. Then, mod A bar, mod B bar, sin theta means here theta is 0 degrees because they are parallel vectors. So, sin 0, it is theta instead of writing theta 0 is given. Sin 0 is 0. 0 and anything is 0. So, here the cross product or the vector product of two vectors, cross product, or vector product of two vectors whose angle is 0, which are parallel vectors, which are collinear vectors, they are always is 0. Hence, A bar cross B bar is equal to 0. The cross product of two parallel vectors, the cross product of parallel vectors is 0. Okay, no? That is the first property. Next. Okay, right? Is it okay? Yeah. Next. The cross product is not commutative. Is not commutative. It is commutative. Commutative means 5 into 6 is equal to 30. 6 into 5 is also 30. Like that. It is not that one. It is not commutative. It is not commutative. A bar cross B bar not equal to B bar cross A bar. Where in the case of dot product, scalar product, A bar dot B bar is equal to B bar dot A bar. It is proved in that topic. In that topic, A bar dot B bar, the cross product. I mean, dot product is commutative there. But here it is cross product is not commutative. It is very important. It is not commutative. Whereas the dot product is commutative. But here one thing, A bar cross B bar, of course it is not B bar cross A bar, but it may equal to minus B bar cross A bar. This is very, very important. It is important. Of course, it is not commutative. But it may equal with negative sign. A bar cross B bar is equal to minus B bar cross A bar. Moreover, cross product is not commutative. Okay, na? Yeah. How we can prove? Slowly you try to understand it. Then you see, as we know, A bar cross B bar is mod A bar, mod B bar, sin theta, n cap. What is n cap? A unit vector. Already we know it. It is a unit vector perpendicular to the plane of A bar and B bar. A bar, B bar are lying on the floor. on that floor. This is where I am standing in my room. Suppose you assume in your room, in front of you, I am standing on the floor on which you are sitting. On that floor, a bar, B bar is lying on the floor. The total for the floor, that means the plane which contains A bar and B bar, I am perpendicular. I told already. I means A bar cross B bar. My foot is horizontal. There is a point A on the floor. Another point B is on the floor. Y bar is A bar. OB bar is A bar, which are lying on the same plane. Now I am perpendicular. I am perpendicular as well as A bar and B bar. And also for the plane of A bar and B bar. Why not? Now I am A bar cross B bar. I am A bar cross B bar. Just like you assume. A bar cross B bar is a vector. Okay? That is a perpendicular to the plane of A bar and B bar. You see, very clearly. A bar cross B bar is mod A bar, mod B bar up to sine theta. This is the length of this A bar cross B bar. Or the magnitude of A bar cross B bar is this one. Is it any? The modulus of A bar cross B bar is nothing but, you see, I am right here. A bar cross B bar, you take it. It is modulus of mod A bar, mod B bar, sine theta, n cap is there. It is a definition. Modulus of mod A bar is nothing but mod A bar. Modulus of mod B bar is nothing but mod B bar. Sine theta is also a number. It is not containing the modulus. But mod n cap. It is mod n cap. N cap is a unit vector. Okay, na? For the unit vector, it is 1. So, mod A bar, mod B bar, sin theta into 1 is sin theta. So, the modulus of A bar cross B bar, the vector product of A bar and B bar is A bar cross B bar. Its modulus, its length, its magnitude is simply mod A bar, mod B bar, sin theta without n cap. Okay, na? So, here it is magnitude and it is directional. N cap means, unit cap means direction. That direction is also perpendicular to the plane of A bar and B bar. This concept is somewhat different. Okay, na? If it is clear, you try to catch it. Or otherwise, you simply leave it out. You learn that A bar cross B bar is mod A bar, mod B bar, sin theta, n cap. Don't think otherwise, anything. Don't go to think about that one. N cap is unit vector. Its magnitude is this one. Okay, da? In the dot product, A bar dot B bar means here only cos theta. Vector means it is a sin theta. Simply you remember that one only. You note it that one. Okay, now we will come to this concept. Cross product is not counted. So, mod A bar, mod B bar, sin theta, n cap. Okay, na? You see, na? Sin theta. Can you write? Sin of minus theta in trigonometry. The last year, I told you. Sin of minus theta is minus theta. Again, minus is there. Already minus is there. Minus sin of minus theta. It is minus sin of minus theta minus sin theta. That is nothing but sin theta. So instead of writing sin theta, I can write minus sin of minus theta. It's okay, da? That minus sent to the friend. That is minus mod A bar, mod B bar, sin of minus theta. Will you agree? Right. N cap is as it is. Here, mod A bar, mod B bar are numbers. Numbers follows. Real number follows. Commutative law. 5 into 6, 6 into 5, 31. So, mod B bar, mod A bar. You see, it follows the commutative law. Sin of minus theta, n cap. Up to this one, you see, na, up to this one. Mod B bar, mod A bar, sin theta, sin of minus theta, n cap is B bar cross A bar. You see, don't confuse. Mod C bar, Mod d bar sin theta sin alpha, you take it sin theta or alpha. Mod c bar mod d bar sin alpha n cap. What is it? C dot C cross A. Will agree? Suppose mod C bar mod D bar sin alpha. Alpha, I take here angle alpha. Not a standard for theta only, it is not defined. For any angle. Sin alpha n cap. By definition, it is a C bar cross D bar. Will agree? Similarly, suppose mod M bar mod N bar sin beta n cap is there. It is a m bar cross n bar. Will you take? Is it okay now? Yeah. Like that, mod b bar, you need out this minus. Here in the bracket, mod b bar, like this, c bar, d bar. Sin something minus theta, let it be. It is sin alpha. N cap. It is by using the definition, it is b bar cross a bar. Okay now? So, now you observe, what we take, we took the A bar cross B bar, we take A bar cross B bar in LHS, and at last we prove that B bar cross A bar. So it is not commutative, but it is equal to this A bar cross B bar is equal to minus B bar cross A bar. This is the proof. Okay, Nanda? So that means with the multiplication of negative sign, it is equal. So it is not perfectly A bar cross B bar is not equal to B bar cross A bar because minus is not there. It is not. So it is also there. So it is not commutative. But it may be equal to minus negative. With negative, it is equal. Okay, Nanda? That is the thing. Third one. If I cap, J cap and K cap are mutually perpendicular unit vectors, then number one, I cross J, first I cross I, J cross J, K cross K is equal to 0. Okay, na? Is equal to 0. Next, now. Okay. Third one, I, J, K are mutually perpendicular unit vectors. That means, see, it is the origin x axis, y axis, z axis. It is I cap, j cap, it is k cap. Okay, now, they are mutually perpendicular. Then, I cross I is equal to j cross j is equal to k cross k is equal to 0. Where I cross J is equal to K cap. J cross K is equal to I cap. K cap, K cross I is equal to J cross. Okay, now? Or, here only, you observe. J cross I, it is minus K, we know it. By using that one, that is second property. K cross J minus I. K cross I is equal to minus J. By using that property. Okay, now, how it is? We will see. Simpler. First one, I cross I. Mod I into mod I sin 0, this is K cap. Be careful. K cap or anything? N cap. I write here only N cap. I cross I, the unit vector I is taking cross product with itself. I cross I only. So angle is with itself is 0. So sin 0. So sin 0 is 0. 0 to anything is 0. Okay, na? Similarly, J cross J is also 0 because J with itself makes an angle 0. K cross K is also 0. Okay, na? So, any vector product with itself is 0. That is, we know it well. So, I cross I or J cross J or K cross K is equal to 0. Yeah, it is proved. Now, the second one. It is I cross J mod I mod J sin 90 degrees. Okay, na? Into here, you don't write n cap. Because here is there unit vector perpendicular to I and J. For the plane of I and J, the perpendicular is k cap. Okay, na? What is? What a bar, what b bar, sin theta, n cap. Where n cap is unit vector perpendicular to A and B. For I and J, the perpendicular is k. So, I write here k cap. Okay, na? Mod I is 1. Mod J is also 1. Sin 90 is 1. K cap. So, it is a K cap 1. So, I cross J is K 1. Okay, na? I, J, K. They are mutual. You know, right-handed system. I to J, J to K, J to K, K to I. X to Y, Y to Z, Z to X. It's a right-handed system. Similarly, J cross K is J cross K. For J and K, I is unit perpendicular vector. So it comes I. Similarly, K cross I is J. Okay, na? It is a right-handed system, the geometrical angle system. Okay, na? It is a right-handed system. This is left-handed system. It is reversed. J to I to K to J. It is a left-handed system. At the time, we get negative values. How can we tell minus K, minus I, minus J? Very simple. By using the second property. Okay, na? Is it clear? You have to learn this thing. These are the formula. Okay, na? That is important. Formula. Yeah. Yeah. Observation. Properties. The fourth property. Cross product is distributive. It is distributive. Cross product is distributive. Distributive with respect to addition. A bar cross of, suppose x of y plus z is there. It is x into y, xy, x into z, xz. Is it that? A of b plus c is there. AB plus yes, this is called as a distributive law. It is a distributive law. Here, distributive law is followed. The distributive property is defined here. Okay, Nana? It is proved in the cross product. Even in the dot product as also, a bar dot of A bar dot of B bar plus C bar is equal to A bar dot B bar plus A bar dot C bar is okay. Even A bar cross of B bar plus C bar is also defined there. But here the thing is, it is the proof of this property is based on the next chapter. The next chapter is scalar triple product of two, three vectors is there, but it is not included in our syllabus. By using that concept, that is scalar triple product of three vectors means, by using that concept, we can prove this one, because three vectors are there. Okay, now? So, it is not in our syllabus. That is why you simply take this one as a statement. Okay, now? Very simply, read out the remaining things. A bar class of B bar plus C bar. Addition. A bar class B bar plus A bar class C bar. Addition means you take minus also. Okay, now? B bar minus C bar also will come. The proof will not be taken here. It is not there in our syllabus. Okay, now? The only statement. A bar class of B bar plus C bar is equal to A bar class B bar plus A bar class C bar. That is the thing. Okay, now? So, that is the fourth property, cross product of two vectors is a distributive. You read on. The remaining things simply read on. Okay, now? Yeah.